While ABS-CBN workers and their supporters staged a noise barrage last Friday, House Deputy Speaker Rodante Marcoleta, Deputy Majority Leader Jesus Crispin Remulla, and Anakalusugan Congressman Mike Defensor were conducting a Zoom conference. The agenda, seizing control of ABS-CBN and operating the network through the help of dismissed station employees.
Pagka kayo nagkaisa-isa, eh pwede nyo talagang patakbuhin yan dahil push button na naman lahat eh. Alam nyo na lahat ng gagawin nyo eh.
Tama po.
In his social media account, Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Loxin Jr. pointed out that what congressmen want to do would be considered trespassing and theft. And according to him, trespassers can be shot. Some senators also frown at the congressman's idea of occupying ABS-CBN. Senate President Vicente Soto III stressed ABS-CBN is a private entity that is protected by the Constitution. The Senate President points out if there are any issues against the network, these should be referred to the courts and be given due process. Senator Sherwin Gachalian said he immediately lost interest in watching the Zoom conference after hearing the congressman's initial discussion. Gachalian says ABS-CBN may have failed in getting a franchise, but the network's facilities belong to the Lopez family.
You can discuss all you want, but if legally it's not possible, then wala rin mangyayari. So, ang importante ngayon ay yung assets ng ABS-CBN is still with ABS-CBN. And no one can use that without the permission of ABS-CBN.
Senator Richard Gordon echoes Gachalian's arguments. With a reminder to his fellow lawmakers, there are more important national issues that need immediate attention.
I think they're out of line there. Besides, I think there are better things to do. Sabi nga, dapat we have bigger fish to fry. Bakit natin pag-aaksayan pa? Nasaktan na yung ABS-CBN. Ang tingin ko, parang lalabas na oppression na yan. At mag-ingat sila dyan dahil may the world, what goes around comes around.
In the meantime, some Catholic leaders voiced alarm over supposed plans to take over the network.
Kung meron ka talagang masamang hangarin, kahit na ano pang pagpapaliwanag sa'yo ng ilang mga sektor, ay hindi mo na ito papakinggan dahil itutuloy mo kung ano man yung hangarin na yan.
Baka naman may mga bagong oligarchs, well, quote-unquote, may mga bago ding oligarchs na kini-create din ang sitwasyon na ito ngayon.
The Catholic Church says it continues to pray for press freedom and the welfare of the more than 11,000 ABS-CBN employees who are losing their jobs one by one. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.